Joining me to discuss this is Missouri Attorney General Eric Schmitt, who has been very, very vocal on this issue, which is appreciated by a lot of people who are wondering where a lot of lawmakers are actually on this issue. And he has said that this is a politically motivated, it is a witch hunt. It's a politically motivated issue, and that obviously he is in disagreement with how all of this has been run under St. Louis Circuit Attorney Kimberly Gardner. The Attorney General joins us via phone. Good to have you, sir. Thank you so much for your time today.
Great to be with you, Dana. And before we get into the serious stuff, it is worth pointing out, you probably wouldn't remember this, but when I was a first-term state senator from the St. Louis area, and you had just gotten, I think, your show on 97.1, I was a guest a long time ago. We talked about, I don't remember what we talked about, but you've gone worldwide now, so congratulations. It's great to be on your show.
Well, thank you. And you've gone statewide. See, I knew you. I'm like, I know him. But I didn't want to be like creepy and be like, I know Missouri Attorney General. So look at that. That's awesome. Thank you. And obviously congratulations on your success as well. How stunned are you? Are you stunned by what happened Friday? I'm not used to hearing about people having their homes raided and their property taken, especially something that is so tied to a natural right, when there's no charges that have been issued. And I know previously police had said that they were not going to issue any charges against the McCluskeys because they were legitimately scared for their lives and they felt as though that they had to defend themselves. What is your take on all of this, and where does this go?
Yeah, well, I think as you've pointed out previously on the show, and I know in your tweets and some of the things you've commented on, what's important for people to understand is Missouri has a very broad and expansive castle doctrine. And the castle doctrine allows you to defend your life, your family's life, your home, and your property in Missouri. And as you led into this, another important fact to all of this for people to understand is that this was private property. These are private streets. This is not a situation where people are on a public street or something like that. They were on their way to the mayor's house, who also lives in the Central West End, not exactly around this area, that has been vandalized several times. But they were on a private street. It was announced to them that this was private. And the castle doctrine is really important for people to kind of keep in mind. But, it's not completely surprising, I suppose, sadly, because if you look at this circuit attorney, the local prosecutor, she has an abysmal record in prosecuting violent crime. At the beginning of the COVID-19, and we called her out on this too, she was releasing dozens and dozens and dozens of inmates who'd been charged with violent crimes, people who had held up at gunpoint restaurant workers and assaulted cab drivers. These were people she was, complicit in the release, back out on the street. And she also has a track record of, politically motivated decisions that aren't based in the law. So obviously this is very concerning. And, the McCluskeys were there on their property, defending their property, and one gun was seized. I think since then, the handgun had been given to a private attorney, which I think had been turned over the weekend. So this obviously is all developing, but no charges have been filed yet, and we're obviously keeping an eye on that as well.
Yeah, the idea that they would, why would they need to seize these firearms? I mean, especially since police have said that they're not going to bring any charges. Is there just some aspect of the law with which and I'm asking actually the Attorney General.
I don't know. As I said, it's interesting. I was going on Fox News Friday night, and we were going to talk about the Operation Legend in Kansas City. Attorney General Barr is, St. Louis and Kansas City, as you very well know, your home state, there are unprecedented violent crime rates happening right now. Kansas City is approaching 100 murders, which is on pace for a record high. St. Louis has 126. Last year at this time, they were like 99. The year before that, like 98. So murders are spiking. And this calls for defunding the police. So Operation Legend was this initiative where federal law enforcement were going to support locals in Kansas City. We're going on to talk about that. And then all of this was breaking. But I don't know. I can't get inside of Kim Gardner's head. Obviously we've disagreed on a great many things, and this would be the latest example of that.
Yeah, I can't imagine that anybody would sign off on something like this. And I know Kim Gardner had said that she was looking to see how she could prosecute this couple for what they did. If something like that happens, like say, I don't even know what charges she could bring, but to not hold accountable the riot mob that vandalized private property and trespassed on private property. And they were screaming threats at this couple because there's so much video footage out there. I mean, and it's all hidden on the internet publicly. To me, I would, and especially since just down the street, several minutes down the street, retired police captain David Dorn was murdered by rioters. Understandably, this couple was in fear of their lives. What would your reaction be, and what could be done by your office if she decides to really abuse her authority and target these people politically while leaving unaccounted for, you know, the actions of all these actual violent rioters?
Yeah, well, and the other thing, too, to keep in mind, if you listen to McCloskey's and the interviews that they gave, you know, sort of the next day as the story, you know, a couple of weeks ago when this was initially breaking, to your point, that the threats that were being lobbed once they announced this was private property and the gate was, you know, broken down and into this private street was that, you know, we're going to kill you. We're going to kill your dog and we're going to come in and we're going to live in your house. And, you know, and so these were, you know, again, according to them and the information everybody has that's out there, these were threats that were being made. And under the Castle Doctrine, they have every right to defend themselves. You know, if they fear their life is in danger, their family, their home, and their property. And again, that's why Missouri, and there's, you know, some other states, but Missouri has a very expansive view of the Castle Doctrine, which is really important. The other thing that's worth pointing out, Dana, is that the day before all of this happened, which seems like ancient history now because everything, news cycles run pretty quickly, but, you know, there were calls to rename St. Louis, which is, of course, ridiculous. And, you know, there was an effort to maybe tear down a statue or a protest, whatever was happening at the statue of St. Louis and Art Hill, which is also, you know, in the city. It's this emblematic statue of St. Louis that's, you know, before the arch was kind of the iconic symbol of St. Louis. And there were calls, you know, and there were people praying at the base of the statue, sort of a, hey, we don't think the name should be changed. And, you know, individuals were assaulted, and it's on videotape. And the people who've assaulted those people have given, like, TV interviews afterwards, and there's been no action taken by the circuit attorney on that. So, obviously, all this is very concerning.
Yeah, incredibly concerning. How long are they able... legal question. How long are they able to keep these firearms from this couple, even though no charges have been filed against them?
You know, I don't want to speculate too much. I don't know what they're looking for, if it's whether they're operable or what. I wouldn't, again, because I don't have any information about that. But, you know, it could be, a prelude to charges being brought, and they're trying to figure out some, you know, criminal statute that they think they can squeeze it into. I would not want to speculate. But the important thing, again, here is the Castle Doctrine is very, very expansive in Missouri. It's not true in every state, but in Missouri, it also allows not just your home, but also your property. And it's undisputed here that this was private property. And, again, I think that's important for people to keep in mind.
Are people able to, in St. Louis, defend themselves? You have city leadership, Democrat leadership, saying that, well, we want to defund the police, we need to seriously consider how much money we're spending on police departments, and yet at the same time, individuals are being punished if they do defend themselves. Where does that leave the average person? We're talking to Missouri Attorney General Eric Schmitt. Where does that leave the average person in the city of St. Louis who's genuinely and rightfully so concerned about their safety, considering everything that's been happening? Now, if they defend themselves, can they expect to now be persecuted by Kim Gardner, the circuit attorney?
Well, that's the challenge, right? That's the concern, is that you have a prosecutor who's made politically motivated decisions not based on the law before. This is now, you know, right in the center of attention. And you do have calls from city Democrats who are on the board of aldermen to defund the police. I mean, these are all facts.
Yep.
You know, I've been out publicly saying we need more money for police officers. We need more cops on the street. And in fact, one bill that we advocated for that may get it, there may be a special session on crime-related issues in Missouri this summer, because these issues are so front and center for so many people. There's a great concern that that violent crime is spinning out of control. And so the legislature may come in for special session. One thing they ought to consider, if they do, and I hope they would get done anyway, is right now in the city of St. Louis, you have to be a resident of the city to be a police officer. And I think we ought to be able to broaden that applicant pool. There's a lot of people who live in surrounding counties, including St. Louis County, who want to send their kids maybe to different schools, but they'd like to do important police work in the city. And we better, you know, remember that we need to support them, those police officers who want to do that dangerous work. But you don't have to look very far. You see record applications for retirement in places like New York. I don't think it's going to be isolated in New York. And for people to feel safe, we need to support those police officers who are willing to do that dangerous work, but also at the same time, be willing to support people's Second Amendment rights as well.
Right, absolutely. One last fast question for you. And again, we're talking to the Missouri Attorney General, Eric Schmitt, who's been very outspoken on this issue. Are you aware of any existing lawsuit that the McCluskeys have against Gardner or the city, or is there anticipation that they may file one?
Not that I'm aware of. I haven't heard that, but again, I hate to speculate.
I know.
Charges aren't. If charges are brought, I imagine that'll be hotly contested.
Yeah.
And you've already seen the sort of positioning on that from the McCluskeys. And but again, I think the law is very clear in Missouri as it relates to the Castle Doctrine, and we need people to stand up. And these calls to defund the police are so dangerous and reckless. When you see violent crime spiking, it's just people deserve to feel safe. There's been too many mothers that have lost their kids and too many kids who've lost their parents. This ought to be a uniting issue. And somehow, you know, people on the left have made this divisive. And we ought to come together and support, you know, good policing and make sure that we've got plenty of cops on the street and also protect people's God-given rights at the same time.
Absolutely. Missouri Attorney General Eric Schmitt, who has been one of the few Republicans that has been gratefully, we're grateful for that, outspoken on this issue because it affects your natural rights, even if it is not in your state. Sir, thank you so much for your time today. We hope that we don't take so long to speak to you again. It's been a pleasure. Thank you.
Take care. Good to be with you, Dana.
Mm-hmm. You too.